This is the XRP Cowboy. Hi, this is Billy.
Rape me, my friend. Rape me again.
I'm not the only one. I'm not the only one. So I'm not saying this is going to happen. However, if Coinbase puts a hold or delists, it's only for one reason, and that's to get our XRP. And I'm going to give you the playbook on how they'll do it if that were to happen. If this is about taking all of our XRP. Imagine this. Imagine it. If it happens. If it happens, what would be the best way for them to do that? It would be first saying they're going to delist it on X date. And it's going to, you know, create a lot of selling. The price is going to go down. And they're hoping it goes down a lot. And then once it's close to where they want it to go down to, you know, that'll be around the date that it's delisted. And now people will be sitting on this. And they're like, okay, it's already gone down 20% or 10%. So we could probably get another 30% out of them, out of what that number is, that it declined. So what they'll do is, once everybody's selling, panic selling, bring the price down, of course it's going to, if Coinbase delists. I don't know why people are saying it's not. And I'm thinking U.S. Binance is strong because they really love Ripple. However, if they're all on the same side wanting it to go down, they'll probably delist too during that. And it'll be timed perfectly to really crush the price. And then what's going to happen? You're going to be bored. You're going to see maybe Bitcoin go up or Stellar go up, something like that. And you're going to be like, I'm sitting on dormant money. So you're like, okay, I can't have my money doing nothing. And since it's a one-way market, Bitcoin used to be a one-way market because they couldn't short it. And it went to 20K on retail investors because of that. Now, we're in a one-way market going the other way. And I know it's all over the world, but U.S. does matter more than they're probably saying. So if it's a one-way market down, meaning people can't buy when it's being sold, that the algorithms are going to go nuts. And drop it. They could drop it below 10 cents easily with that kind of market pressure. And then the people, you know, are going to be like, what the fuck's going on, right? And ultimately, you won't be able to buy it. So it'll drop. Let's say it's at 17 cents and you just sold it because you were sick of seeing it go down and you wanted to reinvest. Whatever happened, you're going to say, but if it drops, you know, 10 more cents, I'm going to buy it, or 5 cents. But then when it drops, you won't be able to buy it because you can't buy it. It's a one-way market. So you can't buy it back to have the price shoot up. And what's going to happen at that point is all the big money is going to come in and buy it when it's down there. And, you know, magic. It's going to shoot it all the way up to maybe $1 or $3 or $4. And you know what's going to happen? You're probably still not going to be able to buy it because it was delisted. And it shot up before, you know, the regulative clarity and everything else. So you couldn't buy it when it was low, and you're not going to be able to buy it, you know, when it's whatever, and yours is gone. So don't sell. This is the playbook they're going to follow if they delist it. If they don't, which they don't have to, the SEC made that clear. They're fined for 5 years, which is odd. So if we see U.S. companies starting to delist it, that is something to think, you know, maybe the flip of the switch. And it's only to switch it over and manipulate the price, of course. Like, theoretically, you know, Brad Garlinghouse when they were notified from the SEC, and it was at 70-something cents, him and his friends could have been the ones that brought the market down, knowing it was going lower. And the SEC's heads up was like, hey, imagine this. We're going to sue you. You're going to settle, but it's not going to cost you any money. It's not going to cost you any fucking money, Brad. You know, because this will create some volatility in the market. We can't say for sure, but knowing, but saying you could sell it up here at 70 or 80 cents, whatever it was, because that could have been the shift in it. You remember, these are people that hold a lot of coins. And then when it drops down to 20 cents, you can buy it back, and you just tripled your money, and you're only settling with us for what you sold off. Pretty much, you're going to make profit on the gains from buying it lower after you sold it off, as long as we get our money. So you're still, you know, even if it dropped in half, you're still even with what you started with. I hope that makes sense. You sell it at, let's just say, a dollar, and then the price drops to 50 cents. You buy back, you have twice as many shares. You pay the SEC off with the 100% profit you made. Only this was more significant. It went down to 20 cents from 70, 80 cents. So they're all going to win here. Isn't that awesome? I mean, that's not insider trading at all. Right? So, hey, I just want to say I love you guys. And, you know, and hey, if you're watching and you're a Bitcoin guy, I'm not bashing Bitcoin. I'm bashing the regulations in the government. I support Bitcoin. I still actually own a little bit, but I just see the gains in XRP being bigger at this point. And let me know in the comments where you're from, because I've been talking to people, and I'm pretty sure they're like on the other side of the world. I'm not sure if that's possible, but let me know. That's pretty cool. And look into VeChain. It seems to be going, you know, doing really well with everything going on, and it's not a U.S.-based company. So that could be a good one, and it's really inexpensive. It's got a lot of room to explode. They're solving a real-world problem with utility. Other than that, remember, the XRP cowboy might lie to you. He's the speculator, but Billy never would. Have a great night. Remember, we're all dreamers, and that's what makes us perfect and beautiful. We can see things clearly because we think in color and in pictures, and we always knew we had greatness within us since the day we could think. You know, when we were kids and we were taking a bath and we're like, God, if I was drowning, I'd find a way to breathe fucking water. Or if you got pushed off a cliff, you'd find a way to fly. That's who we are. Not everyone's like us. Please like and subscribe. I'd like to talk to you guys. Bye. Alexa, play. Alexa, fuck you. Have a good night.